seems a little bit gross, but it makes the ink start flowing and it doesn't like do anything bad to you. So I really like to make things in like a leaf shape. It's one of my favorite shapes to draw right now. But this leaf shape, more like lotus flower type shapes, I really like those. And I also like filling them in with stripes. I'm really into stripes right now. The type of, the style of art that I do for the most of the time is called Zentangle. And for the longest time I didn't know that it had a name until one of my friends told me.
Style that I have now, and that's the Zentangle, and I really like it when I have
switch positions soon because my leg will fall asleep. It always does that. It falls asleep really quickly because I have more circulation. That's why a lot of times, like even in the summer, my hands will be colder than the rest of my body. My hands and feet are always colder. So if I have bare feet on a cold floor, other people's feet might be fine, but mine will turn like purpley colored, and it looks really kind of these days because she's always doing horse things. She does like shows, and she takes a lot of lessons, and she works in the stables, and she also takes care of another lady's horse and rides that horse as well. She's really busy. She's the busiest of us sisters. Thank you. It's subjective. Whatever best shows beauty to you, or best emulates beauty or the good to you, is what is the best art for you personally. You know, within that range of creativity that represents the good, or represents, like, emulates the evil in a way that strives to instruct or inspire. I've got all these definitions written down somewhere. Anyways, I came up with some pretty good definitions that I was fairly happy with. I can't remember them off the top of my head, but I came to the conclusion that art is objective at, like, the base level, but then everything else above the base level is subjective. It's what you prefer, and what I prefer is this. This is a